Good afternoon, everybody. Welcome to your first afternoon video of July. Episode 767, Part 2. Your Days of Praise passages for Friday, July 1st, 2022. Welcome to July, everybody. If you didn't watch the morning video, welcoming you to July. Goodbye, June. Hello, July. Hope this month's good for you. This one we're going to be learning about celestial communion from Zontral Diction, derived from 1 Corinthians 11, 23-26. So if you're excited about this one, give that like button a good old smasheroony. A big old four smasheroony. In lieu of the new Thor movie in a week. Next week. Birthdays, anniversaries, and prayer requests in the comment section below. And also, let me know what you see in this new month. What you're expecting and what you would like to get done this month of July. I know I didn't say nothing in the last one, but tell me what's most exciting for you in the month of July. I didn't get to do that in the morning one, but I'm doing it now when I think about it. So sometimes those comment things, they just come to me. Sometimes I forget to say something and then I'll say it the next one. But subscribe if you do, turn on notifications, share the video and channel with your family and friends, and help me reach a reasonable subscriber amount by episode 800, which is 43 days away. Should be right around August the 13th. Like a light bug. But also, help me reach the goal of 100 subscribers by the end of summer on the calendar. I'm talking about the when it fall begins in September, I would like to be at 100. And if you'll do that for me, I will greatly appreciate each and every one of you that do so. So without further ado, let's see what this celestial communion is all about. Zontral Diction writes, when Apollo 11's Eagle lunar module landed on the moon's Sea of Tranquility on July the 20th, 1969, the space travelers took time to recover from their flight before stepping onto the moon's surface. Astronaut Buzz Aldrin had received permission to bring bread and wine so he could take communion. Oh, that's what they mean by celestial communion. Communion on the moon. After reading scripture, he tasted the first foods ever consumed on the moon. And later he wrote, I poured the wine into the chalice our church had given me. In the 1/6 gravity of the moon, the wine curled slowly and gracefully up the side of the cup. And as Aldrin enjoyed this celestial communion, his actions proclaimed his belief in Christ's sacrifice on the cross and guaranteed his second coming. Guaranteed of his second coming. So the Apostle Paul encouraged us to remember how Jesus sat with his disciples on the night he was betrayed, 1 Corinthians 11, 23. Christ compared his soon-to-be sacrificed body to the bread, verse 24. He declared the wine as a symbol of the new covenant that secured our forgiveness and salvation through his blood shed on the cross, verse 25. And wherever we take communion, we're proclaiming our trust in the reality of Jesus' sacrifice and our hope in his promise, second coming. Verse 26. So whenever you eat this bread and drink this cup, you proclaim the Lord's death until he comes. That's verse 26. So no matter where we are, we can celebrate our faith in the one and only risen and returning Savior, Jesus Christ, with confidence. So that's what leads my home church family. We do it once a month. We do Lord, we call it the Lord's Supper. We don't call it communion, we call it Lord's Supper. And since this the pandemic, we're having where we were supposed to be, we would have trays with the little cups of the where we use grape juice, but for the wine part, they would have a separate trays of them. We had like two trays full of these little clear plastic cups, and in the separate thing, and then we would have a separate dish that had our church got these the communion bread, the little squares of whatever kind of stuff that they are for the bread. And we usually pass out the bread, we take the bread. And then we pass out the juice and we do that. Well, now since the pandemic, when you pass it out, we pass everything out at one time. And then they take the little cups that we put the juice in, they take another cup, drop a thing of bread, the little thing of bread, and then set the juice cup inside the top of that cup. Because these cups, they're stackable. But they put the bread on the bottom, they put the juice cup on inside the bread cup, and then they hand out one cup we get one thing for person. And then you do the bread, and then you turn around and do your drink the cup. Which that's a pretty good idea. That way you don't have to, with the bread being just singly, you don't have to sit there and touch every one of the bread. Everybody gets their own little serving of bread, and if you don't feel like doing that, they have the to-go containers where they got the little cup of juice here, and they got the bread in the. But that works. And if you do it certain, I know when I was down at Word of Life, when I went to the church that I was going to every Sunday, they had Lord's Supper one Sunday, and I was there. Okay, they did the juice, they did that same, but with the bread, they took packs of salt of unsalted, I think it was unsalted crackers. Little saltine crackers, you get them in the little four packs in a box, little stacks of crackers. I take a bunch of them, break them up in little pieces, and you grab it and grab one little piece. That's the way they did that one. But I like our way. I know you may like your way. Somebody else may like their way they do it, but. That's just the way we do it, and that's to each its own. That's what I'm saying. But what has kept you from prayerfully taking communion in remembrance of Christ? How does it make you feel to know that a fellow believer took communion in honor of Jesus on the moon? How do you feel? Let me know if you feel like. But for ones that saw the video a couple days ago, the Days of Praise video, the second video, and had to look at the description box for the phrase on the bottom, you can go back and watch again. It'll be on the bottom. I don't know what happened to it. It just would not go. After sitting for 2-3 hours before going back to it, it still wouldn't take it. So I put it in. And then the next day, when I got done with the other videos, I went back and went in there. It went right on in there. So, and then I deleted it out of the description box. So, it is what it is. But to ponder those questions by saying this phrase, which should be on the bottom of the screen, so make sure your subtitles are on so you can see it. If you don't see it, check the description box. Just by chance, if you don't see it, check the description box. But say, Jesus, please help me to live boldly for you until you come again. That shouldn't take long. Once I let it sit for a few minutes, shouldn't take long to pop it in there. But the Bible reading for this one is Job 21 and 22. And then at the rest of chapter 10 of Acts 24 through 48. If you're a NASCAR fan, 24 and 48 are teammates. At one time, it was Jeff Gordon and Jimmy Johnson. Now it's William Byron and Alex Bowman. Like, whoa, what a world, what a world. But that's all I have for today. Coming up tomorrow in your first Jubilant Saturday Days of Praise video, episode 7. 768 part 2, we're going to be learning about surviving and thriving from Ancetus, derived from Ephesians 4:4-16. So stay tuned for that. I'll get to that in just a few minutes, but you'll see that tomorrow, because I usually do my Friday and my Saturday videos in the same sitting. So, and all week I've been doing 2 days and then do another 2 days. I used to do that, you know, 2 days, 2 days, 2 days. And that way we wouldn't have to worry about recording every day, but I just started doing it every day, and it's been working. But, I ain't. Start doing it 2 days again. Probably do Saturday, Sunday. Or no. Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday. I might just do Sunday by itself, because I've got Days of Praise or the Turning Point Weekend Series, and then I get it on Monday, do Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, or get on Monday, do Monday, Tuesday, then Wednesday, do Wednesday, Thursday, and then come back in Thursday night, do Friday, Saturday, or whatever. I might just do Sunday, Monday. And it just depends on how I get it done. But it might get one day have to do three. So I could Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, and then do then on Tuesday do Wednesday, Thursday, and on Thursday do Friday, Saturday. But coming up at 7 o'clock tonight is your first Turning Point for the month of July. We're starting a whole new book, which it's right there. And our first passage, episode 279, we're going to be talking about not long or loud. Beginning with Matthew 6, 5 and 7, our recommended reading is Luke 18, 10 through 14. Our turning point is from E.F. Hallock, H-A-L-L-O-C-K. And we're moving on in the book of Proverbs with Proverbs 4 through 7. And then I'll give you a rundown of what everything is all about in that video for the new month. And there is a good weekend series coming up for July. So I've already looked at it, and it looks pretty good. So can't wait to get to that one when I do. So, but with that said, I love you. I appreciate you. Thanks for watching. Sorry for a little longer one. But I know I was done by 9 minutes, and I was sitting there talked and rambled. But thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed it. I love you. I appreciate you. Keep on keeping on and trusting God, and He'll keep you safe and all you say and do in 2022 and beyond. And until later, peace. Peace out, everybody. So long. Farewell. Come back again later after 7, and we'll start the new month of July's Turning Point book, and we're starting off with Not Long or Loud. Sounds like a good one. So until then, God bless everyone, and I'll see you then. Goodbye.